I ended the stream. I keep getting fouls calling me. I played 7 minutes. Like, I'm not gonna get 50 points. I'm not gonna get 50 assists. 15 assists. I'm trying to get assists, and the nigga's missing shots, and they're taking hella long shoot the ball. Second, yeah, I can't make a three. I'm 2 for 4. How am I missing shots? I have a 91 three pointer. It's not part. This is fucking my career. I'm fucking pro. I'm on pro, bro. I'm not even starting. Are you kidding me? You starting Pat Will over me, man. A sinking Pat William. Now we're losing because you idiots. You put me in the game after a minute. What was the point of even taking me out? Clamps up, nigga. That's not a foul, man. Thank God. You gotta get the rebound, man. Yes, sir.
Did he ever live up to the pick? No, he never did. Care. He was a little bit undersized and ultimately was not a good fit in San Francisco. But for the Raiders here, maybe you see some potential. You have a very intelligent football player, somebody who has always shown that he works extremely hard. I don't want to use the common phrase, the Gruden grinder, but that does remind me of the type of pick we have here with Solomon Thomas. So go down to the comment section right now. Give me your one-word reaction to the Raiders signing Thomas. We are live here on the player. Of course, if you're just excited at a free agency and you love the Las Vegas Raiders, if you give me a like on this video, man, I would really appreciate it. Just got done filming over at Chad Stewart from the main live show, and then I ran over here as quick as I possibly could. Threw on my Raiders shirt, and I was like, okay, let's get it down to the Raiders report. So what's your one-word reaction? I got face plant says boo. We got a who in there. Tony Collins says solid. I'm with you. Then he says it's Juju. If you're the person out there that says go get Juju Smith-Schuster, I don't even really want to talk to you right now. I don't really want to
Cause I got it. Cause I have it. I ain't broke. Money chain, bro. This dude's like my money chain. It's like all money on it. It's not like a chain, but my money.
Now you also have Jalen Pearl and Max Lodge, so that's basically three solid edge rushers there. And if you need help at defensive tackle, you'll go out and get somebody like Jonathan Hankins. You brought him back. But Solomon Thomas just adds depth. He adds extra boost up the middle. The Raiders really wanted somebody that could get after the quarterback, something that Thomas did in college, and he's never really been able to show that's what he does in the National Football League. But the Raiders wanted a defensive tackle that they thought today could have confidence in really being able to get after the QB. Hopefully, the whole Solomon Thomas thing works out a little bit better than Malik Collins did. So if you guys super chat right now, we got over 1,000 people watching. I'm going to go ahead and throw it up on the screen. Jack Bishop, Mitch, we need a big-name cornerback or free safety or wide receiver. If I got to pick between all three of those positions, I'll take free safety. If I could go out and get a guy like Anthony Harris, I'd be totally on board for that. Also, potentially a guy like, I don't know, Richard Sherman's been thrown out there. Casey Hayward's been thrown out there. And I actually also have some breaking news here. The Chiefs add Kyle Long. So the Raiders won't have an opportunity to have Kyle Long. He decides to join the Kansas City Chiefs.
Fuck Kyle Long.
Join the enemy. Let's now go to the next super chat. It's coming in here. It's from
he's not. You're not a real Raider, bro. Your dad's always be a legend. You'll be a bitch ass.
Yeah, it's a much better day. I thought it was funny how Monday everyone was like, Yannick Ngakoue, 2 years, $26 million. Like, I saw the deal, and I was just doing this to my seat. And then the next day, it's Rodney Hudson's cut. And then the next day, we trade Rodney Hudson. We bring back all these players. And I understand that some people aren't excited about John Brown. John Brown's actually a pretty good deal. If you could tell me I get John Brown for 3.5 up to 5.5, or AJ Green for 8.5, I think the John Brown deal every single day of the week. And I do think that he could actually fit with what the Raiders are trying to do.
I don't know about that.
Now you add a little bit more depth here with Solomon Thomas, so I'm in agreement with you, man. I agree that today is a much, much better day. Hopefully y'all are having a good day, and if you are, go ahead. If you love the Raiders, like the video. All right, this next one's coming in here from Remy22. Salute, Mitch and chat, Raider Nation. Everyone right now, go down to the comments, start spamming Raider Nation for life. If somebody in the chat sports studios could go grab me a beer or something cold to sip on, I would greatly, greatly appreciate it. Another super chat coming in here from Harrison F. Any chance of getting Anthony Harris? Also, any news on getting depth for tight end wide receiver? So, like, the whole tight end depth thing, I don't really see why the Raiders need to add too much extra depth. You have Nick O'Leary if you wanted to ultimately re-sign him. But you have Foss Moreau. You have Darren Waller. Maybe they add a guy in the draft. If you want to go out and add a cheaper option, it's potential. But tight end's not a big need. Wide receiver, I actually don't think they're going to go out and make any more moves. And if they do, I will actually be pretty surprised by that. I would love Anthony Harris. I also think Malik Hooker are probably your top two most likely options. Malik Hooker, though, if I had to be a betting man, be the safety the Raiders ought to sign. Another super chat here is flowing in from Josh Viola. Are you happy with the current signing? I thought Yannick Ngakoue was an A+. I mean, 2 years, $26 million. That's a slam dunk for the number one edge rusher, number 1-4-3 defensive end that I had on my list. So A+ there. John Brown, I gave it a B- grade. In my grading scale, B is good. A is absolutely phenomenal. C is average. So I thought John Brown was a B-. And then also Solomon Thomas, that's probably around a C grade for me. It's an average pickup. It adds a little bit of depth. I'm not saying it's going to totally transform our defense, but he is still a young player, going to get a brand new look.
What are you doing? Hey, we could have had an easy dunk. Daniel Gafford, you really who the one is.
Had a contract that's pretty reasonable, but I'll also say this to the Raiders. A lot of one-year contracts, which I like, and a lot of one-year contracts for players who are going to try to prove it and are going to try to get that big payday when the salary cap goes back up. So what do y'all think here? Name another player that the Raiders should go out and
We need a safety, man.
They signed John Brown. You brought back Denzel Good. You brought back Richie Incognito. And then today, also, you go ahead and sign Solomon Thomas. You also were able to bring back Nicholas Morrow, who has obviously...
We get a safety now? Oh, we need a corner. Trust Trevor Mullen. Did we or not give him one more season? Maybe two more seasons. I'll give him more. I'm on the trade. Maybe he can last 12, 4 years. I heard he was in development. Trevor Mullen, dude, time to develop. I had him for a couple years. I was not a fantasy, you know. Just in the pool. I came for a couple years. He didn't start there. I traded him. He was selling with the Broncos.
Name a player that the Raiders signed. I'm going to take a sip
But Arnett never developed, but I think he might actually have it around. I think Mahler's gonna be a pro bowler in the future. He'll be a traded to the bottom. Maybe actually, I don't know. Ooh, boy. Real
promising Jay Gonzalez hits the thing. Daniel Rubio says Anthony Harris. Forrest Lamp from Bay Troll, solid offensive lineman. We'll see. Another Anthony Harris, Richard Sherman from Jesus. We're going to get to some more super chats after I shout out.
I'm going to have Sherman and whoever the fuck Anthony Harris is.
Just signed with the Kansas City Chiefs, so that's a no-go. And Antonio Brown, no bueno there. I just got some Brown. And then more Anthony Harris's. Mitch, you're amazing from Rodney. You know what? It's not just me. It's the entire chat board team. Shout out to Tom. Shout out to Marshall, Harrison, Brett, Chase. Sam, I mean, the entire team, if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have been able to make this show happen as quick as we did. Shout out to the team at Chat Sports. Everyone, go ahead, spam Chat Sports. All right, we got Super Chat coming in here from Cliffman Michael. Mitch, one-word reaction to Solid. Who's next? We need help at quarterback and safety, but what's the plan? Are we onto something here? I think the plan was this. You wanted to be able to rebuild your defense as much as humanly possible. In order to do that, and in order to keep Derek Carr at the contract that he has, you have to then go out and make some other moves. The moves were not really being able to bring back Nelson Agholor and really trimming up your offensive line. Las Vegas is all about rolling the dice. And that's exactly what they did. They rolled the dice with Richie Incognito. They got him back. They rolled the dice with Morrow. They got him back. They rolled the dice with Denzel Good. They got him back. Sure, you did get Nelson Agholor, but major, major shout out to the Raiders who were actually able to get some draft capital back after basically saying, Rodney Hudson's gone, he's not going to come back. That's how good of a center he is, though. The Arizona Cardinals took a chance. They're going to have a very, very good center unless he was still in silver and black. But I think the plan is this. Build depth, build the defense, and really try to build a younger offensive line. And if anything else happens, you know, we'll try to keep you guys updated.
You see, yo, offensive line, right? We have a 37-year-old, no, literally retired. Came out of retirement, literally injured this whole year. And besides him, but Rodney Hudson, no, we good. The best center in the NFL, he's better than Jason Kelce. I don't care, he's younger, he's also a year younger, maybe 2 years younger. No, and he can't even retire before. But yeah, like the Eagles offensive line is old as shit, too. You see him get rid of him? It's Peterson might retire. I thought Peterson might retire, bro. You're 40 years old. He's not going anywhere. No one's going to sign you. Retire, bro. I'll get your back. Yeah, it's your last contract. Get your back. And retire. Jason Kelce. I'm down to bring Jason Kelce to the team. Makes no sense, though, but. I'd rather have Jason Kelce than Rodney Hudson. You want to leave us? Like, fuck you. I like Jason Kelce because he said he wants to win. He gave his heart out. You know, he's a center.